Please take it away. Marty Krueger.
Thank you, Dennis. You realize that you used up 3 minutes of my speaking time. Congratulations on this, what appears to be an extraordinary conference. I really appreciate you bringing up this, the age of the Hilton, because I finally found something that's older than I am. The Hilton was built 1 year before I was born. It's a wonderful feeling. It's a privilege to be here. I really feel like I've reached the big time when I can be on the same podium as Judy now. I know you're going to introduce Judy shortly, but I can't resist talking about Judy for just a minute. Not many people realize how important the role of the chief engineer at the FCC is, but Judy manages 100 or more constituencies, all of whom are asking him for something, and to whom he delivers never as much as they want, but enough to keep them happy. He is an extraordinary guy. He has been referred to by some of the commissioners as a national treasure, and I subscribe to that wholly, and it is my honor to be on the same podium as him. But the real reason I'm here today, excuse me, is because of you, because you represent the career that I had for most of my working years. Except that you guys have one advantage I didn't have. You know, when my mother asked me what I did for a living, I'd have to tell her, well, I'm in the two-way radio business. At least some of you can say you're in a glamorous business like autonomous cars or transportation. My mother would have preferred that I was a lawyer or a politician, or maybe even a reputable job like a doctor or a judge. But somehow she still loved me, and I prevailed. It's been 55 years since I headed up this group. I was not president, I was chairman. The group was not a society, it was a group. But we've grown up since then. But a lot has happened in 55 years. I'm not sure you realize that 55 years ago, there were no personal computers. The integrated circuit had not been invented. There were no digital cameras, certainly no cell phones or cordless phones. The pager, the citywide and nationwide pager, had not yet been invented. In 1963, we had just introduced the first nationwide mobile telephone, which weighed roughly 40 pounds, which had a digital control package. It comprised 130 transistors. And I personally had to work hard to cut that number down because we couldn't have afforded many more transistors than that. That compares with the modern cell phone, which, as you know, has on a single chip over a couple of billion transistors. So a lot has changed in that 55 years, but there's one thing that hasn't changed at all, and that is the myth that there's a scarcity in spectrum. That spectrum is like beachfront property, that there's only so much of it, and there won't ever be any more. And those of you that have heard me talk before know I don't believe that. I believe that there's never been a scarcity of spectrum, and there never need be one in the future. I believe that we technologists will always stay ahead of the demand. I did an observation, starting with Marconi, who was the least specially efficient of any engineer that ever produced something that had to be, that involved wireless. And from the time of Marconi until now, we have doubled the throughput of the entire spectrum using the most modern techniques every 2.5 years. Doesn't sound like much. It turns out that every 50 years, that's a million times improvement. So we, in fact, today are like 10 trillion times more spectrally efficient than Marconi was. And we have the ability to carry that on with techniques that we know about for at least another 50 or 60 years. Quite remarkable. Now that doesn't mean that everybody uses the latest techniques, because they don't. We have the history of the broadcast, television broadcast industry, who starting in the late 40s developed a protocol that they ended up using for over 50 years. The same protocol where they, the television channel used 6 megahertz of spectrum. There were 17 additional channels that were used for guard bands. And they somehow managed to hold on to all of that spectrum, not because they needed it, because they owned it. The FCC finally fixed that. And then the television industry is now 100 times more spectrally efficient, and they should be even more so. And I'm not sure the FCC is going to fix that sometime in the future. It's the FCC that made cellular as efficient as it is today, because the FCC made the allocation of cellular spectrum, and those of you that know about land mobile, that the SMRS was created on the condition of increased spectral efficiency. The FCC said that you can have new spectrum, but you can't have it unless you get more spectrally efficient. So